throw it to you right over here. See, there's the salad. There's this asparagus. There's this and that. That's for the salad. And right in here is all the barbecued ribs and boars and hot dog looking creatures. Kimberly's in charge of eggs, peeling the many layers of the egg. There's about 50 layers in a chicken egg. And she's gonna get through all the...
Very difficult.
Doing a good job, better than I can do. And our guests will be here in about 3, I think. Because they know that's when the food comes out. Sounds like a fork went down to the garbage disposal. Now we have mint leaves, limes. We actually have a carbonated water machine here that makes carbonated water. That's carbonated water right there.
Pretty cool, huh?
We've got a sugar. Mojito.
Mojito.
Mojito. It's Indian. It means it's Indian.
It's actually supposed to have rum.
It's a rumless mojito. Mojito.
Right.
So that would make it a virgin mojito. Wow, amazing. This is an art. Now where did this originate? What's the history on the mojito?
Is this a Brazilian thing?
No, that's a Cypriot.
It's a what?
Mojito originally came from Cuba.
Cuba. It sounds kind of...
I believe.
It's kind of Spanish. How's it taste? This is the proof's in the pudding. Now this is where we find out. Anyway, Matt. Voila!
Did you try it?
Perfecto.
Try what?
Perfectamente.
No, I haven't.
This is really good.
Try it.
That's it. Lenny?
You don't want germs.
Isn't that good?
Hey, it's very good.
Isn't that good?
Very good. I am, yes. That's impressive.
That's successful so far.
Okay, we're in business.
Isn't that good?
That's pretty impressive.
We're in business.
Yeah, it's like very refreshing, isn't it?
Okay, I'm going to go document the other room anymore. Is the sous chef released, or does the chef have other things, assignments, until they get here?
Well,
I'm the sous chef.
Something might happen.
The sous chef.
What's a sous chef?
It's the assistant. It's the associate pastor of the kitchen.
The assistant chef.
I made myself that. Because Kyle's the chef. But where's your white hat, Kyle? And your white apron.
I forgot. I blew it.
We got an LA Lakers. Los Angeles Lakers chef hat. I guess some of them have that. Who is it? Dean Faring of the Mansion on Turtle Creek. Dean Faring has an L.A. hat that he wears when he's cooking in the mansion. The famed chef, Dean Faring. Yeah. Yeah, he's been he's so good now, they had him on TV. But he always wears a ball cap. But they always have to wear Dutch shoes. They wear the baggy striped pants with the Dutch shoes.
Yeah.
but when strangers come, they get all...
Yeah, well, then now that they're settled down, let's cut them out.
It's all right.
Tell Jeb what Kyle was yelling on the way down the mountain.
Kyle is funny. He was, Kyle was yelling, Schleicher Brothers dominate the mountain!
That's probably true. I remember the first time you guys got
Yeah, I remember going with you guys.
Off the cornice.
The cornice
Well, what, yeah, what we...
They almost, were shocked because that's
They almost killed me.
What we lacked in finesse and style, we made up for in aggression. You're aggressive.
What are you going to do though, Jeb, if your sons go off and they say, come on, what are you going to do?
Yeah, you sort of go again.
So.
I'm a lot more cautious than I
was,
that's for sure.
I think Craig's on his way, isn't he?
Sandra was having morning sickness in the afternoon. So.
You look great. And I heard you've been through the battle. We were praying for you. We had a prayer meeting yesterday. Our dad has a meeting at the restaurant, so we were praying for you.
I got good ones. That's what it's for.
Oh, good. Well, you must have had 25 pounds.
Are you making
my
heels?
Plus the...
Put them in that book.
All right,
thank
you, buddy.
Thanks, you guys. So how long do we have to, for you? How many more years? Two? How long do we have to be?
6 years.
Yeah. 2 years?
One with a Pepsi can.
What? You got married
in 2 years. Pepsi can. Oh, yeah. That was one for
you. We saw Bridget, Craig. Craig's the friend.
Yeah.
We should show them
one.
Craig and Bridget.
Oh, yeah, yeah. You got to see this.
When are you guys leaving?
They spent some time looking at old houses and where they lived in Laguna.
Yeah, you might have a better memory of that than my mom because you were older, but apparently, like, my mom didn't realize that. That almost everyone who was in Idaho was down there.
There's Corey and her daughter, Alexis.
But your grandmother?
She lived with Uncle Clyde for a while in, believe it or not, life. And then they came over to... they brought her down maybe for a couple months. She's pretty ill. But that family... my family. Uncle John settled in Laguna Beach, and Hilda settled in Laguna Beach, and of course, my dad did for a short time, you know, because he had the boys' camp there in Laguna Beach. And of course, Uncle Clyde and Hilda lived right on the ocean front there on Crescent Bay Drive, beautiful village. And before that, they lived on another street. I can't remember. There was a lot of family members there.
Yeah. Those
are two. Ida's little house now is a bed and breakfast.
The
other one's a
blonde Darren. The blonde Darren and a miniature Corey. Now, Craig, do you have any names picked out?
What we did is we downloaded a bunch of names.